If you have your Bible with you, I would like you to turn with me to the book of Proverbs, chapter number 3. Proverbs chapter number 3, I'll be reading from verse number 5. Proverbs 3, verse number 5. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding. 6. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Amen. Yes. The verse 5 says, trust in the Lord with all thy strength and thy might. Lean not unto your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. I want us to look at the verse 5 again. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart. You see? The word trust means total and complete yielding to something or to someone. Are you listening to me? Yes. It's like sometimes when you watch film, you see that maybe there is a big river which there is a boat that carry cars, they normally call it launch. It carry cars to cross to the other side. Those who move their cars into that machine and those who carry their luggages inside that machine, they have really trusted the machine and trusted the driver or the controller of that machine. It's like traveling from here to US and traveling to from here to UK. You put your whole life into the hands of two pilots to take you there. Have you ever considered it? That your whole life depends on these two men. You trust them that they will take you to your destination. Sometimes you don't even think of how this big thing can take off and be hanging in the air. You just go and take your visa and then you just buy your ticket and then you just march to the airport and you are gallivanting around the airport, making calls and telling people that you in the next 15 minutes you'll be off, you'll be in the air. Have you seen the seriousness of it? Then they announce that everybody should fix his seat belt and then everybody should take off. The plane's about to take off. Then before you realize, with top speed, then it takes off, then it's in the air. Once when I travel and I was by the window side, it looks very frightening. Very, very frightening. Those of you have been traveling a lot, you are used to it, but for the first time I traveled on a plane, it was very frightening. As you look at this gigantic, huge bed on the ground, you understand? Then you go and turn and come with top speed and then take off. And when it's going like this, then it's going, it becomes stable. You see, going, you can't, it's not like a road you are driving, or you shall see your front. It's only two people who are seeing the front and they are telling you something. You don't see anything. You just see side and side. They are only people seeing the front and they are telling you that for the next 30 minutes we will get to our destination. You trust that those two men and you put your whole life on them to take you to your destination. That is what it means to trust. Or you are going, those of you take trotro most times or taxi most times, when you sit in the trotro, there is nothing show that the trotro is okay to take you to where you are going. You just say Medina, hachu, hachu. You just jump inside. You don't know whether the tie is okay. You don't know whether there's oil in the engine. You don't know whether you are just going. That is what it means to trust. To trust means that you forget about everything and look direct onto something or to a person to take you to your destination. So here the Bible is telling you that trust the Lord, you understand, with all thy heart and lean not unto your own understanding. Don't think like, oh, what about if it doesn't work? What about if it doesn't happen? What about if this doesn't work? Don't think about that. Just rest in Him. That is what it means to trust. Amen. So trust is a very powerful force. And you can put your trust into anything. Because there is nothing like us for me, I don't have trust in anything. If you don't have trust in God, trust in something. There's nothing like you are an island. There's nothing like that. There's nobody who says, I don't trust in something. Definitely you have something you trust. Either you trust in your money, or you trust in your wisdom, or you trust in your education, or you trust in your family background, or you trust in your children, or you trust in your husband, or you trust in your wife, or you trust in your family. There is always something you trust. Because if there's nothing to trust, God won't tell you that trust Him. It means that your trust can be in the wrong thing. Amen. Yes. And sometimes when you're trusting some things, you may not even take notice of it, but you're trusting some things. It's like now, if you are coming to church, you have dressed up and then you start your car, that your car didn't start. If your trust is in your car, you remove your clothes and then stay at home. That is what it means to trust. Amen. Yes. So definitely there is something you always put your trust into. There's nothing like I don't have trust in anything. You definitely, if you don't deceive yourself. There is nobody who says he doesn't trust in something. Maybe you have not discovered what you trust, but I'm telling you today, you have something you trust. Sometimes you can trust in yourself, but you don't know you trust in yourself. Sometimes you can trust in your family because you don't know you trust in your family. Sometimes you can trust in your ideas that you don't know you trust in your ideas because trust is a bit blind. Someone is blind when you trust something. It's like you are not aware what you trust. It's true. You can even trust in a human being and you don't know you trust in the human being. Amen. It's like you are trusting in me. There's nothing wrong of trusting in me, but I'm limited. I can die. I can be sick. Are you listening to me? I can be weak. You can only join your faith with my faith and we can do something together. But you cannot say you trust in me for you to live. It's not possible. I am not saying that as a pastor you can't trust in me. But I'm telling you that there are limits to trusting even in me. What about as you came to church, you didn't see me? And all your trust that is going to lead us, or pastor is going to lead us to pray, very powerful prayer. You came and then you realize that brother Emeka is standing here and say, let us pray. You can be highly disappointed. Or you walk here today and you find out that there is nobody here. No, I'm not here. Mommy is not here. Nobody is here to lead you to do anything. The instrumentalists are not here. You'll be highly disappointed because your trust and your focus is in men. So you cannot trust me to take you through life. You can only join forces with me to take you through life, because two is always better than one. You can trust me for God to use me to bless you, but you can't trust me as the final of your problems. But most often we trust blindly, because everything I stand here to say is not mine. That's the half problem with people. When you give them maybe prophecy, they can get angry with you because they think it's you who is giving them the prophecy. To be a prophet means that you receive and give. A prophet is just like a speaker box. This speaker box here doesn't have contribution. It doesn't need to debate or argue. Whatever I am saying is what is repeated. That is what it means to be a prophet. To be a prophet means you repeat exactly what you are told. That's what God told Ezekiel, said, prophesy to the dry bones. It means I say what I'm telling you to say. So there's nothing like a prophet comes and he says something, then you are angry with him or you are annoyed with him. No, because he just heard it and is saying what he's hearing. If he's not hearing anything, he can't say anything. So a prophet speaks like the way speaker box is. The speaker box repeats. Whatever I'm saying is coming out of this thing. If I'm not saying anything, nothing will come out. So there's nothing like, pastor, prophesy to me. There's nothing like that. It's when you hear, is when you deliver. So you are just like a speaker box. You recite, you repeat whatever God is saying. So there's nothing like you are angry with the prophet or you are annoying with the man of God because he says something that God said that it didn't go well with you. Are you listening to me? Uh-huh. So trust simply means that putting all that you have into something or to a person or into God, that's trust. And when you trust in something, you are not shaking. You are sure of what and where you are standing. So say, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledging. Meaning, when you declare that you trust in God, you don't take certain things into consideration. Follow me and I'll make you fishers of men. And they abandoned all their nets and followed him. That is trust. The disciples of Jesus, when he met them by the shore with their father washing their net after fishing, Jesus told them, follow me and I'll make you fishers of men. And Peter them all abandoned their net and followed him. That is trust. So trust means that you abandon every other thing and then you focus on one thing. That's trust. Amen. Yes. Whatsoever it tells you, do it. Trust. If you trust, you will obey. There is nothing like I'm obeying, but I don't trust. What will cause you to obey is the trust you have. What will cause you to listen is the trust you have. What will cause you to move is the trust you have. So here is telling you that if you are going to experience all-round blessings and all-round safetiness and all-round security and all-round good things, you must trust God all-round. Trust God all around. Trust God with everything that you have. Trust God with it. Trust God with your money. Trust God with your life. Trust God with your marriage. Trust God with your business. Trust God with your education. Trust God with everything. It means that there is nothing you do that you don't involve God. Everything you do, you involve God. Meaning you trust him. So everything you do, you involve him. You are going to marry. You trust to give you the right partner. You pray to God to give you the right partner. Are you listening to me? You are going to rent a house. You trust God to lead you to the right house. You are going to buy a land. You trust God to give you the right land to buy. You are going to travel. You trust God to lead you to the right country he wants you to go. You want to go to school to do a certain course. You trust God to give you specific course that will make you to progress. You trust God all around. You don't take anything to consideration that Whatever it doesn't work, whatever it doesn't, you trust God for everything. Leaning on your understanding means considering everything. Go and fall into River Jordan 7 times, and your sickness will go. Rise up and take up your bed and walk. When the word came, or when the word come to you, it is trust in the word that will make you to act on the word. Without trust, you can never. There are people who have been here, and there have been prophecies that go to your country. There's a lot of Nigerians who came. God told me to tell them to go to their country and look for a land. And at that point in time, they don't even have money to buy a land. But they trust in the word which was spoken to them, and they took a step, and they called people in Nigeria and told them that, I want 5 plots of land. I remember once Brother Favor's friend, Valentine. The day he came to the church, there was a word that he said he prayed that God should speak. When he came, God spoke a word that he was going to get a land. There are some specific word that came. You see, so the word came and he believed the word. He trust in the word. No, the danger in it is that if you are not careful and you put your trust into wrong places, you may not have anything. But here, God is telling you that put your trust in him. Why we cannot listen to God? Why we cannot obey him? It's because we don't trust him enough. That's why we can't listen to him. Because it is sure that when you trust God, you listen to God. There's nothing you are told by God that you will refuse to do. Amen. That is what trust does. When you trust in someone, you commit yourself to the person without considering anything. All you know is that he is able to take me through. That's trust. And all of us have opportunity to trust somebody or something. We all have opportunity. And we all have choices to trust. But as where you trust is very important. Because whatever you put your trust in, if there is a shaking, nothing will come out of that trust. You hear people saying that, oh, as for my husband, without him, I have no life. As for my family, without them, I have no life. It means that there is an amount of trust you have in them. There's an amount of trust you have in them. So when they are no more there, you have no grounds. But the most important person you can trust and be sure of is God. You realize that there are things that will make you trust God. When God created the sea, God said to the sea, you can roll, you can do, you can. But when you get to the shore, you can't go further. And from generation to generation, the sea can be rough. But when it gets rough, it doesn't cross over to come to town. Except maybe there is a judgment. God wants to bring upon a particular country, and you allow the sea to cross its boundary. He tells the sun, you rise from the east. Every morning you see the sun from the east. He said that there shall be day and there shall be night. If a man or somebody has commanded such things and it is like that, when you trust in that person, you come for. You see, you come for. Why God says you should trust him? Because he knows that any other thing you put your trust in, you will surely fall. And in these last days, a lot of people will fall. Because we have so many people who have put their trust into so many things. Some people put their trust into political parties. Some people, all their trust is in a party. So they will fight, they will kill because of a party. Someone trusts in his boyfriend or his girlfriend. He will do everything to keep that relationship. That is his trust. You know, without that, he cannot survive. Someone can do everything to keep his a bank account so that nobody will tamper with the bank account. I don't say every time making sure the bank account is saved. Some people have gathered money, too much money in their bank. They are not giving it to anybody. They are not sharing it because all their trust is in the money. Some people's trust is in their business. You have a beautiful shop or a beautiful investment, and all your trust is in it. And the way you walk when you are going there shows that your trust is in it. I have a bad news for you. Remove your trust from that thing. This week, there was fire outbreak at Dummy Market. Shops were burned down to ashes. If their trust is in it, their end has come. How the fire came, you can't tell, but there was fire. If you trust in your car, when you sit in your car, the way you sit and chalk and drive, to show to everybody that this is your life, this is machine. My friend, I have a bad news for you. That car can catch fire because it's an electrical car. Can catch fire. This week, we're going somewhere, and then we wake up and we have dressed neatly, and then we sat in the car. We sat in. When we're going, everything was okay. As we got to say, realized that I couldn't hear anything again. Everything is off. Engine is off. Everything is off. Steer has become hard. You can't turn. Goes automatic. I managed to park. Disappointment. We said to ourselves, by 10 o'clock, we need to reach there. We got there almost 1. We have calculated our time that at least by 1:30, we have to be at home. We got home 7:30. That is to say to you that you can't even trust in car. So stop priding yourself in material things because they have a limit and they can disappoint you. Don't even trust in your education. I have PhD. I have diploma. I have this one. It's paper. Fire can burn them. Burn it to ashes. You can't even find it. Are you listening to me? Don't even trust in your spectacles. If you have eye problem, don't trust in them. Trust in God to help you see. Because they all created your eyes. What about, I watched one Chinese film some time ago, and there was this Chinese Lapo in the film who used to go around and be reporting things. And they realized that he was the cause of it. And they removed his space and stepped on it and crashed the space into pieces. He couldn't see anything again. Anything material doesn't have future. If you want to pride yourself in the fact that you trust in God and He will never fail you. You trust in your company, the company can collapse. So God is telling you that trust in Him with all your heart. I am not saying don't go to school. I am not saying that don't build a good business. But no matter what you build and no matter what you acquire in this world, know one thing, that the power behind it is trusting in God. Living in Him, trusting in Him, believing in Him, and living for Him. When you do that, I can guarantee you, no matter how tough things become, no matter how terrible things become, you will still survive. You will still survive and you will still stand and not fall. How do you do so? How do you trust in the Lord? Considering all the things He has done. It's simple. How can I trust God? There are a lot of things God has done or we have seen in nature that can convince you that God is trustworthy. It's true. It's trustworthy. Do you know when you go to sleep? And do you know when you wake up? You have no idea how you sleep. There's no man here that can tell me that he know when he went to sleep and he know when he wake up. That tells you it's a mystery. When you lie down, you don't know how you went off. And you don't know how you got up. That is the power of God to convince you that without him, you have no life. How do you walk? You have the audacity to say, I'm going to sleep. Tomorrow morning, I'll go to the bank, cash some money, and go and do this and go. You have the audacity to talk that way. It's God who made it to happen for you. It's God that makes you to sleep and wake up. Every organ in your body is God who makes it to work. You are not better than those who have cancer of the blood. You are not better than those who have a stroke. You are not better than those who have all kinds of sicknesses. You are not better than them. It is something called the goodness and the mercy of God that has kept you far away from that trouble. So it's not by your strength. Remember what the Bible says. It's not by might, neither by power, but it is by my spirit. Years ago, I learned something very, very miraculous. We used to pray for people who want to travel. We pray for them to go and get visa and travel. Are you listening to me? There was this lady who came from one of the regions, far away. It's beyond Kumasi. It will go far. And the uncle was living in Germany, and the uncle gave invitation that she'll come to Germany. And the day she came for us to pray, she only had a passport. Previous, we have prayed for people who come with volume of documents. They have this document of their company, that document of their company, this document of their company, this document of their company. So they are sure that with all these documents and their bank statement, definitely they will give them the visa to travel. We pray for them, they go, and so that they turn them down. The prayer is not answered. Why the prayer is not answered? Because when the prayer is answered, they will not give the glory to God. They will give the glory to the document which they have. When they ask them, so I really prepare myself. So they reject them. This is talking with only passport. And when we pray, say, me wafa or to Germany or see mimbrana mimraho. Just pray for me and let me go and take my visa and go. She just sounds like somebody who is not normal. Because you can't talk that way. Only passport, they say, come to embassy. The following week when she came, visa was in her passport. What about those who with file and document? They were rejected. Because it is not he who will it, nor he who ran it, but it is God that showeth mercy. It's to convince you to know that when you don't trust in the document, you don't trust in what you know, but you trust in the power of God, the power of God will take you through as normal as it takes through others. You see, that is what it means to trust. To trust means that remove all kinds of images you have created for yourself and all kinds of people around you and only put your trust into him, knowing that he is able because you consider the things he has done. You know, if you don't even know what the Bible has written about God, certain material things, physical things will tell you. I'm telling you the truth. I saw some invention that some white people has invented some car. That the car is huge. It's not really, it's like a tractor. Huge. That when the car is there, the top can reach. So I look at it and say, what a wisdom. For men to have an idea to create a vehicle like this, you know that God is powerful. Yes, you know that God is powerful. So to look at these things, it will give you enough strength to believe that when you put your trust into such a man, he will not disappoint you. If we are going to go through these last days and be victorious, we must remove our trust from things and put our trust into God. Let's look at something in the book of Mark chapter 10. Rise up to pray. Mark chapter 10. Reading from verse 17. Mark 10, 17. And we'll rise up to pray. This was the story that the Bible recorded about a certain rich man. And when he was gone forth into the way, there came and running and kneeling to him and asking him, "Good master, what shall I do that I may inherit eternal life?" What must I do to be able to inherit eternal life? 8. Jesus said unto him, "Why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God." 19, quickly. "Thou knowest the commandment, do not commit adultery, do not kill, do not steal, do not bear false witness, defraud not, honor thy father and thy mother." That is the 10th commandment. 20. "And he answered and said unto him, Master, all this have I observed from my youth." 21. Then Jesus, beholding him and loved him, and said unto him, "One thing thou lackest, go thy way, sell whatsoever thou hast, and give to the poor, and thou shalt have treasures in heaven, and come and take up thy cross and follow me." 22. "And he was sad at that saying, and went away grieved, for he had great possession." You see, the point here is not that Jesus don't like people who have money. This is not the point. Jesus is not making a point like, "I don't want rich people. If people rich people want to follow, they have to give all that. They have to sell everything and come and follow me." You know, the point is not Jesus telling us that he doesn't like rich people. Are you listening to me? The point is that he does not like rich people who put their trust in their riches. And that was the man's problem. The man's problem was that he cannot afford to lose his riches. Jesus said, "Go and sell everything you have, all your investment, everything." And today it is happening to us. It's happening to us in the kingdom. There are things God wants us to do. Because we don't trust him, we can't do it. We can't do it. It's a sign that we don't trust him. That's what we cannot do. Because when you trust in somebody, you will do whatever he tells you. Amen? Yes. Even prophecy, it's not everybody that believes in prophecies. Are you listening to me? It's not everybody that you give prophecy to know that they believe in it. So we see people who believe in the prophecy we give to them, or God uses us to give to them, are special people. Because it's not everybody who can believe in what you are telling them. What will make them great? What will make them strong? What will make them successful? Jesus told them, "Go, sell everything you have, and give the money to the poor, and come and follow me." Meaning, take off your trust. Remove your trust from your money. Remove your trust from your wealth. Remove your trust from your investment. Remove your trust, because you cannot, it's not guaranteed. It can be wiped in a second. Most rich people don't serve God well. Most rich people, they don't serve God. They serve their money. Even when they go to church and they preach a message, that doesn't go down well with, you. They won't go to that church. That's what some rich men will tell you, that they don't go to a church they are older than. They go to churches that are very old. So they won't go. I don't believe in these little churches that have come that they are always making noise. I believe in going to church that the priest will wear gown, come and stand there and preach some simple message. Now go. Because he trusts in his money. And that was the situation of that man. The man trusts in his money. I'm telling you today, those of you who are coming up, God is blessing you much more. Change your mind from trusting in money, because it doesn't have, you don't have future with money. Money is good. Cars are good. Nice houses are good. Nice family life is good, but you can't trust in it. It can vanish in a second. Career can vanish. Investment can vanish. The only thing that cannot vanish, and the only person that cannot vanish, is the creator of the heavens and the earth. And that is the one I'm recommending to you. Remove your trust from many things you have put your trust into. So you walk in a certain way. Always know that you have this, you have that. My friend, walk like this because you know God. You believe in him. Don't work like because you have this, you have that. I can guarantee you, you will fall. In a second, you will fall. You remember Japan? In the twinkle of an eye, the sea came and washed everything away. Billionaires became bankrupt. They became empty. They became useless. They became sad. Everything was gone in a second. Oh, I belong to this party. I belong to that party. I can guarantee you have no future. The only way to survive and to see yourself moving on and on and on is to put all of your trust into God. Put your trust into God. Wherever you find yourself, put your trust. Don't become like the rich man. The Bible says he was sad and then he left. He left. Let's conclude that part quickly. The 23. Quickly. And Jesus looked around about and said unto his disciples, how hardly shall they that have riches enter into the kingdom of God? It is hard. Then let's continue 24. Quickly. And the disciples were astonished at the words. But Jesus answered again and said unto them, children, how hard it is for them that trust in riches to enter into the kingdom of heaven. It is hard. People can't go to church because they have money. They have cars. They have investments. They go, oh, what am I going to do in church? What am I going to do in church? Even people cannot lift holy hands to worship God because they trust so much in their money. If I have not pastored for long, I've pastored for a period of time, and I have seen people with money reduced to nothing. I've seen a lot. I've seen people who move from low area to high area and ask me to come and dedicate their house in the high area, like places that only high and rich people live. And I met them after some time, and they were looking for a single room to rent. The future is not in your hands. Your money cannot save you. You've seen rich men who are sick in the hospital, and they cannot breathe. Their money can't save them. Their family can't save them. They fly them to South Africa, fly them to India, fly them to different countries, and they cannot still survive because your money is limited. God is unlimited. God is unlimited. So no matter how rich you are, no matter how poor you are, no matter how strong you are, no matter how weak you are, one thing I recommend to you, trust in the finished work of Jesus. And trust in the one who died and rose again on the third day, because he has the ability and the power to save your life. trust in him. Money is just paper. It can fly away. Don't trust in money. Don't trust in your wealth. Don't trust in your... I've seen people with passport. I remember years ago, one man came from Germany. All his passport is full of visa. The passport got missing. Find the passport. So if your all your trust is in your passport, because you have all kinds of visas in your passport, so you can't talk to me like this. You cannot. That passport can get missing. Anything material is limited. If you're able to travel from here to America and come back, it is God who has helped you. It's not because you are smart. Because there are people who said they were traveling and they met people at the airport and they said, oh, please, can you hold my bag for me? I'm just going to washroom and come back. And they can't find them. Before they realize, their bag is full of coke. And today they are in prison. Today they are in prison. Yes. Someone can trap you. A trusted friend you believe in can put you into trouble. I'm telling you the truth. What you need in all of your life, all of your existence, is not money, it's not cars, it's not houses, it's God. You need God in your life. You don't need all those things. You need God first, and those things are added to your life. So that your trust is only to God, and those things are just to assist you and support you to live. Some people can trust in their shoe, the shoe they wear. People can trust in the bracelet, the chain, the gold chain they wear. They don't trust in it. Are you listening to me? Some people can say, as for me, I don't drive any Korean cars. Me, I like German cars. Those cars, when you have accident, you won't die quick. My friend, forget it. Any accident is accident. You will die. As for me, I don't want to drive any low-class car. Have you seen people, they were sick, they put them to hospital. They have fresh Mercedes parked in their garage. They can't even come out to drive. They will carry them in the wheelchair and put them at the back. And some fianga, ruffian, nigga will just sit by the sea and be driving and tell you that. He said, Pastor, say, there was a man like you that we were bringing to church before. He has Mercedes. Mercedes, it can't drive because it can't see. Whenever he's coming to see me, he will go and call some mechanic to come and drive. The mechanic will drive and be driving him. And one day I say, why are you not coming? He said, the mechanic have been driving speed. When I tell you, keep quiet, he said, no. So I can't want to, you see. Don't look at your shoe rack in your room. You have arranged it from top to down. Designer shoes. And look at it and say, and stand in there and take picture. Say, watch me. One fire. You even find one talking under your shoe. It's gone totally. Trust in the Lord with all your might and lean not onto your own understanding. In all of your ways, acknowledge him and he will direct your path. This is all you need in this world. You need God. You need to surrender your life to him, trust him, remove all your trust. You know, some people, when they start getting small money, start walking a certain way. You know, money and things, they have a way they make you to behave. Because when you start trusting things, it will give you a lifestyle. Some people, they are walking normal like that too. Immediately they buy one car, they get one building, they don't walk the way they used to walk again. They will slow one side of their shoulder and raise the other side. Some people say, you can't talk to me like, do you know who I am? You are nobody. It's like watches. Whether you are wearing designer watch, you are wearing any watch, all is time. Every watch gives time, am I correct? So the watch you are wearing shouldn't make you pompous. every shoe be shoe. Whether designer shoe, mosquito shoe, alligator shoe, is shoe. So long as you are not working barefoot, a shoe. Don't be proud because you are wearing designer shoe. Don't be proud that you are sleeping in the house in East Legon, or you are sleeping in the house at Ajigano. Any house that rain won't beat you is a house. Am I correct? Uh-huh. Drive Mercedes MK. Those who drove Kia and came, we all have arrived. Am I correct? Nothing to boast about. All I'm sending to you to humble you is that trust in the Lord and remove all your trust from men and from things. You will live and you will survive and you will progress in life. Education is good. Money is good. Good life is good. But don't trust in them. They can vanish. So Jesus was telling the man, I want you to remove your trust from your money. Give it to the poor and come and follow me. Come and follow me. Come and follow me and trust in me. If we are able to do that, I can guarantee you, friends, no matter what come on this earth, we will survive it. No matter the shaking, no matter the troubles, no matter the storms, you will survive it. Because your trust is only in God and not in man. But when you don't listen to what I've told you and take step according as I've instructed you by the word of God and go back and still trust in these material things, you have yourself to be blamed when there is a shaking. One of the shaking was when this virus came. I remember once we went out to buy something around Atomic Runabout, and there was this guy who was driving this unlicensed, unregistered car. It was Mercedes, nice Mercedes, was driving. And when he got to the police, the barrier, they asked him to return with his Benz. He was pointing, there was going, he was got out, said, oh, he was going to buy something. The police was saying, go back. If there was no virus, it would have passed. The police will salute him because of the Benz. But with the Benz, they return him back. That tells you that there is a time in a man's life, nothing is guaranteed and nothing can save you except trusting in God and walking with God. So if you have come to the service this morning, put your trust into God that every prayer we are praying here, we are going to pray here, God is going to take you through that prayer point and see you through with a breakthrough. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. Love God. Submit yourself to Him. Worship Him. Let Him know that you trust in Him and not in things. Are you listening to me? And it will take you through every step and every stage of your life. May God give you more understanding in the Word of God. May God give you more strength to believe. May God give you more power to trust Him. And I believe that from 2020 onwards to 2021 onwards, everything that will come and every challenge that will come into this planet Earth, God is going to take us through. And we are going to end victoriously with a testimony. God bless you. Rise up.